Yarmus is an ex-colleague. He was member of the parliament. He left it to become now deputy foreign minister of Greece. So
and I had the pleasure of the MP that succeeded me was status. So it's just two comments. I'll try to keep them short. The second is a kind of answer to what Dimitris has just said. There is a trap. Walter Benjamin, writing after the defeat of the Spartacists, was writing about the melancholy of the left. That is, after a defeat, we can consider our ideals, revolution of the manifesto, as a sacred but unattainable object. And then, instead of becoming a source of inspiration for struggle, it becomes a kind of substitute, of sacred substitute. I say that because, contrary to what many of us seem to believe, there is a revival of at least the left of the social democracy. And especially in the countries where uberization and globalization are more dominant. Great Britain and the United States. And why this happened? Exactly because the crisis is a major opportunity for the left. Why is that? What was the basic legitimacy glue of all post-Second World societies, but especially the European Union? I say especially for the European Union because although it was a noble dream, it was always an elite-driven project. And why did it have a wide popular legitimacy? Because it improved the everyday life of the European citizens. And now we have for the first time the European Commission saying in the white paper that we are the first generation of Europeans who fears that our children are going to have a worse life than ours. That's why this glue is now dissipating. And of course there can be two replies. The one we have seen in last century, in the interwar period, to try to find scapegoats. Instead of Jews, now the refugees and the immigrants. And there is the other, to try to find a democratic and socialist reply to that. What's happened in the left in the United States and the UK is exactly that they have broken with this tradition of just cultural left, just rights of the difference, which are not unimportant, but now are embraced by everybody. EPP does not have a problem with the European Parliament, with LGBT rights, whereas it does have a serious problem with anything to have with class struggle. So my idea is exactly that we must seek the opportunity. The opportunity is exactly what Dimitri said. Different currents of left to be united in order to find concrete replies, and that's why I completely agree with our with my colleague, the constitutional lawyer, saying that it's not federalism, another question. Another question is how to politicize and thus democratize the process of decision-making in the European Union. I'm finishing with just a small point of divergence in order to, if there's time, to have a reply. It's true that we cannot have European Federation to the extent that we do not have a European demos, not nation, demos. But I think that we could have a European public space instead of parallel national monologues. What I'm saying is slightly different, maybe very theoretical, but when Varoufakis or Schäuble were speaking, what they were saying, it has been translated throughout the European Union. It ceased to be a German dialogue or a Greek dialogue. So I think that on some issues, crisis, refugees, we are now before the creation of a European public space, beyond the national dimension. And this offers a hope for rallying exactly all these forces that are for democracy and social change in Europe. And I'm personally very optimistic. We have the chance to change the situation, exactly because those that are up cannot anymore rule as in the past. And those are below do not want to be governed as in the past.